Hey, it's me, Theocrat Andera again. As long as I was putting up my tent, I thought I would go ahead and put out my bedroll and talk about what I sleep on and in. Let me see here. Sorry, I gotta move the camera. So I guess the logical order would just be to go from the top down. My outer layer is a waxed canvas bedroll. It started life as a 15 foot by 4 foot tarp that I folded in half and stitched down the side, making an envelope, like a sleeping bag type deal. It's waxed with a combination of beeswax and soy oil, vegetable oil. Took it a long time to dry out, but it is water resistant. It's not waterproof, water resistant. It's heavy, so I will probably only carry this when I'm camping and expecting bad weather. It's just not worth the weight if it's going to be bright and sunny and dry. But underneath that, actually, now that we've talked about that, I'm going to jump to the bottom layer and then work my way up. So, very bottom, I have a Therm-a-Rest pad. I'm not a young man anymore. My bones ache. I have joint problems. I cannot and will not sleep on the ground, directly on the ground anymore. I don't need to put myself through that. I camp to have fun, not to hurt myself. So, Therm-a-Rest pad adds a little bit of cushioning and some insulation to keep me off the cold ground. On top of that, I have this fake fur rug. It helps camouflage the Therm-a-Rest pad. It adds just a little bit of cushioning and hopefully just a little bit of warmth. I haven't actually had a chance to try the rug out yet. I have used everything else in my sleep system, my bedroll, but the rug is new. Hopefully I'll be able to try that out before too long. Next up, the core is this fleece blanket. Again, it's a synthetic fleece. A few reasons why it's synthetic were the cost, the launderability. I can bring this home from a trip, throw it on the washing machine, throw it in the dryer, get it clean, and it's ready to use the next time around. Also, I do eat a plant-based diet and try to avoid animal products as much as I'm able to, as much as is practical. So that was a consideration as well in choosing a synthetic rug and a synthetic fleece as opposed to the real thing. But with that said, the next layer is a wool blanket. This is merino wool, real cheap. I think I picked this up at IKEA. And then next layer is another wool blanket. This one is heavier. It's a much denser weave. This is actually one of my cloaks that I don't wear terribly often. The lavender just doesn't match very well with the green forester garb, so I don't wear it a ton unless I'm wearing brighter colors. And when I'm not using it as a cloak, I use it as a blanket. And that brings us back to the top layer, the waterproof or water-resistant bedroll. I have used this gear down to about 32 degrees, freezing. And I was comfortably warm. I made it through the night way more comfortably than I thought I was going to. I did wish I had a little more padding between me and the ground, not to stay warm, but just for comfort. If I was out in the forest somewhere, out where I had access to leaf litter, pine branches, some sort of vegetation where I could make myself a debris bed, I would. camping in my backyard. Unfortunately, that's not an option. So it was an uncomfortable night. It was warm, but it was uncomfortable. So that is, you know, a quick rundown of my bedroll, my sleep system. I will add or remove layers as conditions require. You know, a summer trip might just be the Therm-a-Rest and the fleece. Maybe the Therm-a-Rest, the fleece, and the lighter weight wool blanket. Winter camping, I'm using it all because I don't have anything to prove. I don't need to show anybody how tough I am, how much misery I can endure. I want to be comfortable when I sleep, so I will carry the extra weight just so I can sleep comfortably. Hope this helps you guys to figure out how to make your period camping gear or period appearing camping gear work. If you've got any suggestions, any questions, let me know. Love to talk gear.